Welcome to WebStylePress. All web browsers ship with a set of default styles that are applied to every web page in the user agent style sheet. Most of these user agent style sheets are open source and you can have a look through them. For example, I have this HTML document. I have linked custom.css that is in my assets folder and in styles folder. And I have got here one paragraph and one list inside a div with class inner, and that is inside a div with class main. Right now I don't have anything in the CSS. This is custom.css sass. I'm using sass that will be giving me output in the custom.css. And if I look at this document, and this is the output. You can see this is the paragraph and this is the list with some space at the left side. So if I right click at the document and click inspect, I can see there are some default styles that are being applied to this document. You see, I have selected this list here and you can see from styles we have got display list item and text line. This one, this style is being applied via user agent style sheet. And if we click at the body, and then at the body we have got display block and margin 8 pixels that is being applied via user agent style sheet. This is the default style sheet that is included in the Google Chrome that is I'm using right now. So every web browser ships with default style sheet, and you can actually look through them by going here. This is the style sheet. This is the user agent style sheet, default style sheet that is shipped with the Google Chrome and Opera. And this is the style sheet that is shipped with the Mozilla Firefox. And this is the style sheet that is shipped with Safari. I will include the links in the description so you can check these out. So these are the style sheets, and these are user agent style sheets that are shipped with web browsers. So every web browser has got some default styles for every element that you use. We have to reset these styles. A lot of styles are consistent across all user agent style sheets. However, some styles are inconsistent between the user agent style sheets for different web browsers. For example, you can see how an input field is styled across all web browsers. It is different. In order to deal with this inconsistency between user agent style sheets, we use CSS resets. A CSS reset is a set of styles applied to a page before any other custom styles. The purpose is to create a more standardized base between different web browsers. You want to make sure that your website looks the same across different web browsers. That is why you should include a CSS reset rule in your style sheet at the top of your style sheet. So we have got this main div. This first div with the class main, let's style it a bit. If I use it like this, if I use padding and I use 40 pixels, you will see the padding here. This is the padding. But if I make it 100% in width and save it, you will see that we have got a horizontal scroll now. Why? We have got this main and we gave padding to it, and padding should be internal spacing, not external. Why it has pushed the document and content that is appearing to go outside of the viewport? This is because when you set a width height of an element with border and padding, the element often appears bigger than you have set. Because the element's border and padding are added to the element's specified width and height. We will use a CSS property that is box sizing that allows us to include the padding and border in an element's total width and height. And we will do it by using CSS reset. So we should include the CSS reset at the top of document, and we should use it like this. Static means this CSS reset rule will be applied on each element in your document. We will use box sizing and we will use border dash box inside it, and then we will use margin 0 and padding 0. So this is our basic CSS reset rule, and that is being applied on every element in your document. Include this rule in every CSS that you use. I mean in every CSS that you will use for your whole project. Use this CSS reset for every CSS that you create. This CSS reset is very important, and what it will do, let's see now. See, the horizontal scroll has gone, and the spacing for this list has gone also. So you will reset the CSS consistencies and user agent style sheet, and then you will apply your styles for your web page that will look consistent across all web browsers. Now let's see at the output for this SAS file. This is my CSS file that is being included in the web page, and we applied box dash sizing border box, and we have got this prefix. Use this prefix as well. This is WebKit prefix for this property. Use both of these. It will make your CSS consistent with other browsers as well. And so this is our final CSS reset that you should use for every custom CSS that you write for your web page. If you will follow this one rule to reset your CSS, you will face less problems. You will face no problems in making your web page look consistent across all web browsers. I hope you like this video, and give it a thumb up. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe, and I will see you in the next tutorial. Take care.